Dear students, in previous video we have discussed up to second phase, the portrait of a lady by Jaswant Singh. In this first two phases, one is village phase, village life, and second phase here city life, or here village school. Author used to attend, or the narrator is highlighting here the village setting, then understanding of the village area, rituals. So this concept is very important, that when we are thinking about the two different settings, in first setting village life, village dogs, temple, and the village routine, then scriptures, prayer, all that things here it is mentioned. In the second phase, very important thing it is mentioned, that there was a turning point in the relationship. Then in the third phase now, this first little bit we will revise from the second phase. Second phase, new school, especially English school, then English culture, understanding of, means lack of understanding about the new modern education, prejudice about the education, and then generation gap, little bit rigidness, grandmother is not able to mold herself as per the new era. So she herself started thinking in such a way, and then the gap of the communication was widened, and slowly slowly now it become the rare, means rare communication. And now in the third phase, again there will be problem. So now we will today discuss the phase number third. We will start. When I went off to university. So now in second phase, high school education. In third phase, university education. When I went off to university, I was given a room of my own. So what is difference here in the second phase and third phase? Second phase, grandmother and author, they were sharing the room. But now here, author is highlighting one more important thing, that I was given a room of my own. The common link of friendship was snapped. The common link of friendship was snapped. The reason would be, what would be the reason? The reason would be here, that now there will be very less communication, and because of that, the common link, that common bond of friendship is also snapped. And this important thing afterwards created so many problems, and that problems now we will discuss. So my grandmother accepted her seclusion with her resignation. And now grandmother started thinking. Grandmother started thinking actually in the wrong way. But here the resignation, from what she wanted to give the resignation. So now she started thinking that I have to leave without grandson. Means there would be loneliness, and that loneliness sometimes curbs your mind, and it is same here also happened, that she has done the same thing. Means the grandmother started thinking negatively, and that kind of resignation, she was trying to leave all that things and she would join the prayer. Next line, she rarely left her spinning wheel to talk to anyone. So now there is pressure on her mind. What kind of pressure? Pressure of that negativity, pressure of loneliness. And when he will personally feel that now there is a problem and no one is there to communicate, and how can I would cope up? Especially senior citizens, now they are in the phase of second childhood. So love, care and small things also, if you will not share, they may think that now their status or their, because of old age, others are not paying attention. And that phase, when we are observing, then we have to take care in that phase. But now university education started. Author is not there. Here author is highlighting that he had given a separate room. And because of that, what happened next, we will think. So here she rarely left her spinning wheel to talk to anyone. Means she would be sitting in that spinning wheel and she would not think about that she would go and communicate with anybody else. Then from sunrise to sunset, she sat by her, means here, wheel spinning and reciting prayers. Means from morning, sunrise to evening, that sunset, she used to sit on that spinning wheel. And what she used to do? Prayer. So she used to pray the Godness. Here clearly we can highlight that she was facing the problem of loneliness. Only in the afternoon she relaxed for a while to feed the sparrows. So in the afternoon she used to relax herself, and here to feed the sparrows. In first phase, what was the first phase? Village. She used to give sales apartments to the village dogs. So here again, that love for the birds we can prefer. Only in the afternoon she relaxed for a while to feed the sparrows. While she sat in the veranda, breaking a bread into little bits, hundreds of little birds collected round her, creating a veritable bedlam of chirpings. And this is her continuous activity. So if such type of thing it is continuous, then animals would have that habit, and it is their also daily routine to come there. And one by one, the sparrows may increase and they may be there around the grandmother, and it would look like a veritable bedlam of chirping and their chirpings. And when sparrows, if you observe in reality, you can observe that if more sparrows than that chirpings, it is very nice sound you can. You personally experience that, then you will understand. Some came and perched on her legs, others on her shoulder. Means that love, she is thinking in positive way about the birds. And when you will register, when you will harm any animal or bird, that bird will not come to you. But the love, that affection, if you will have, then what will happen? That there would not be any problem would occur. So here, because of that attachment, some came, means some birds or the sparrows came and perched on her legs, others on her shoulder, some even sat on her head. So if any bird would come and sit on your head, how you would think. But here, grandmother, because of that love, attachment, and that common feature, what is that? One thing here, she is lonely, and grandmother is also in a phase that she would also think about the company, and then sparrow should give the nice company, at least for some sort of time, but that is the thing, very important thing for the grandmother. She smiled, but never shoot them away. And she used to smile if any sparrow would come and sit on the head also. So such type of happy environment is created. But here, it used to be the happiest half hour of the day for her. And it would be the very less time. Means the whole day, she used to sit from morning, means sunrise to sunset, evening. She used to sit on that wheel and spinning wheel. So here we can understand only it would be the happiest. Why the word happiest it is used? Rest of the time there is no one to communicate. So it would be the happiest half hour of the day for her. And that half hour would be the happiest. That she would be happy to do all that things. And that was the very important thing here, author is highlighting about the grandmother. Then, afterwards, after this third phase, what happened? When I decided to go abroad for further studies, now again, new thing. Author or the grandson would not be there in the city. Now, grandson had decided to go abroad. Again, one more problem here. I was sure my grandmother would be upset. And here, author is clearly focusing that I was sure that grandmother would be upset, she would be unhappy. I would be away for 5 years. So here, period of time author is mentioning that 5 years, and 5 years it is not a less time. Every day from morning means to evening, if somebody would be lonely, how you would feel? And that loneliness creates so many problems. And in that year, and at her age, one could never tell, but my grandmother could. She was not even sentimental. So here, sentimental, this kind of aspect, it is very important, but here it is mentioned as a, she was not even sentimental. She came to leave me at the railway station, but did not talk or show me any emotion. Suppose somebody is leaving you for 5 years, there would be tears. Because departure scene, but here in the departure scene also, because of the communication barrier, because of lack of communication, and she had already decided the resignation from all that things. So here we can observe, what is the observation? We can observe that different behavior, it is not expected, this behavior is not at all expected, but unexpected behavior we are observing, that is, she came to leave me at the railway station but did not talk or show any emotion. And this is the phase here. Something wrong would happen in the future. So we can understand. Her lips moved in prayer. Her mind was lost in prayer. So this is again important, right? Her mind is not in the communication. At least the grandson is now leaving that place, leaving that city for the education. And for that education purpose, if he would be going somewhere, then at least while going, means in that journey, what would be the more preference of any person? You would more focus on the communication. But here her focus is not the communication, her focus is changed. So here her fingers were busy telling her beads of her rosary, means her mind was lost in prayer. So all the lines, if you will observe, means her focus is not communication. She was not thinking to communicate with the author, but she was involved in the prayer. So this is the important thing. Then one more here. Silently she kissed my forehead, and when I left, I cherished the moist imprint as perhaps the last sign of physical contact between us. Means here there is a thing, means mechanically now everything it is done. There is no love, affection, it is observed, attachment. Means she has done the task, but that attachment is not there. And so here, cherish the moist imprint, perhaps the last sign of physical contact between us. So here, author is mentioning that she should have that different behavior, but here, this behavior is totally unexpected behavior from the grandmother. The grandmother was not at all interested to speak with the author. So why this thing happened? Because of the communication barrier. Because of the prejudices about the education. Because of the generation gap. And one more thing, that everybody should miss the, there is a role of others also. They should also think about the grandmother. Means communication is very important for the each and every person. But that was not so. After 5 years, I came back home and was met by her at the station. Okay, now departure scene, we are observing her different unexpected behavior. After 5 years, if somebody is coming, then arrival of the grandson would be the happiest thing. But here also, again, we are observing that same nervousness, unhappy, upset thing. And what is that upset thing we are observing? She did not look a day older. She still had no time for words. Means she was involved in the prayer. She is not interested to speak with the author. And while she clasped me in her arms, I could hear the reciting her prayers. And during that also, she was just reciting the prayers. Even on the first day of my arrival, her happiest moment were with her sparrows, whom she fed longer and with frivolous ribbons. So here, we have to think about one more thing, that her priority was to feed the sparrows, and that was her happiest moment, not the arrival of the author. So this phase is very important phase, and this is the actual negative thing we can think now, that it is the clear resignation from that friendship. So in the beginning, friendship was good. Then in the second phase, there was a turning point in the friendship. In the third phase, the bond and common link also snapped. Then next, when author decided to go for abroad for the studies, again, then communication barrier here we can observe. The gap it was widened, and now, while departure scene and afterwards, after 5 years also, come back, arrival also, there was no any moment from or any priority thing. This happened on grandmother's side. So this is a very important thing we can notice. Now what happened? In the evening, the change came over her. She did not pray. She collected the omen of neighborhood, got an old drum and started to sing for several hours. She thumped the saggy skins of the dilapidated drum and sang of the homecoming of warriors. We had to pursue her to stop to avoid the overstraining. That was the first time since I had known her that she did not pray. And she started beating that drumming, the overstraining was there. And here, author noticed that this is the first time. Observed that she did not pray. Means there was only one thing it was remained with her, that was her prayer. And now she stopped that prayer. Means this is the clear sign of her death. Right? Afterwards, she killed her life. Because prayer, the common thing, very important thing, now she stopped because it was her regular routine. And if someone is changing the regular routine suddenly, and that was her soul, means she cannot do or cannot stop praying because she was the religious lady. So this year we can focus that when we are thinking about the such type of personality, means the grandmother's personality, she may not do, means she will never think about the, she would not do the praying. But this year we are observing that that was the first time since I had known her that she did not pray. Means here, author, everyone, they have taken care. They were convincing her, persuading her, but she did not listen to anyone. And finally what happened? The next morning, she was taken ill. And there was a mild fever. Means it was a mild fever and the doctor told us that it would go. Means it was the mild fever, but doctor was also suggesting nothing will happen, it is mild fever. But my grandmother thought differently. She herself decided to quit. So here, grandmother thinking differently now. She told us that her end was near. She said that since only few hours before the close of the last chapter of her life, she had omitted to pray. She was not going to waste any more time talking to us. And now, she is not interested to speak. She stopped that prayer, all things, and she would not be interested to speak with anybody. And now this is the clear sign of the death. So if somebody would stop doing the things or stop responding, then counseling is very important at that time. But here, the role of the counseling is not also working because the depression, the level of depression was high. We protested, but she ignored our protest. She lay peacefully in bed, praying and telling her beads, even before we could suspect her lips stopped moving and the rosary fell from her lifeless fingers. Means now this is the death scene. That she started doing the prayer and nobody understands that when the death occurred. Means here the line is it is her lips stopped moving and rosary fell from her lifeless finger. A peaceful pallor spread on her face and we knew that she was dead. So this is the case that when we are observing, we can understand that there is no such type of thing would happen now. There is a clear sign of the death and this death scene. Afterwards again, author is highlighting some more things about the animal, their love, emotions, how that attachment also creates the animal or birds. We lifted her off the bed and as is the customary, laid her on ground and covered her with a red shroud. After a few hours of mourning, we left her alone and making arrangement for the funeral. Means the now the funeral after the death, we would arrange all that things. But here the reference it is given about the sparrows. That first I would notice for you. What is that reference it is given? We stop halfway in the courtyard, all over the veranda in her room, right up to where she lay dead and steep wrapped in the rain. Was no chirping. And here there is no chirping. Sparrows were there, so many sparrows were there, but there was no chirping. There was a silence, drop silence like that. How human being we are keeping the silence as like the same silence here we can observe. We felt sorry for the birds. Here at that time here author is mentioning that we also felt sorry for them. And what is their behavior? Sparrow's behavior we can understand. Skip web in the red shroud. Thousands of sparrows sat scattered on the floor. There was no chirping. So thousands of sparrows were there, but there was no chirping. This is the case. And here, one more thing we can notice, that mother, when she broke it into the little crumbs, the things. But the way my grandmother used to and gave it to them, the sparrows took no notice of the bread. So here, what is the, she broke it into the crumbs, means the breads of crumbs. Now birds, if you will throw something, then they will take and they will go. But due to the attachment, due to the relation, it was maintained with the, or the bond with the grandmother. Now grandmother is lifeless. There is only the corpse they are observing. So how, where they will sit on, how they will sit on the head of the grandmother like that. Animals also have that emotions, feelings. So here clearly it is picturized. When we carried my grandmother's corpse off, they blew her away quietly. Next morning, the sweeper swept the bread crumbs into the dustbin. So here, they have not taken any notice of that bread crumbs, and they flew away without taking that, and quietly, silent, silence means here, when you will give your contribution in any field, or when you will have that love or the bond to any person, or animals, or birds, you would get the same in return, and that is what we have reflected in the lesson. So what do you do? Read the lesson carefully. Think about the question answers. In the next video, we will discuss question answers. Thank you.